hurts my neck. Oh, gosh. Oh.
So welcome to another episode of Ask Olaf the Violin Maker. Today I'm going to talk about something that I'm kind of passionate about, and it's not so much about the instrument, but it's about the player. I meet a lot of string players, and I meet a lot of high-level professionals, and I meet a lot of people who hurt themselves playing a stringed instrument. So today I'm going to talk a little bit about health and how to keep your body relaxed when you're playing. String player health nearly never gets taught by any teachers, and it's so frustrating because I see so many string players who end up in a lot of pain playing. Just this week alone, I met two string players who've had some real issues. One was a cellist and they're having some issues with their fingers. And the other one is a viola player who played on a really large viola, and it ended up creating some injuries as well. And so firstly, let me just say how important it is that you play the right size of instrument and that the instrument is set up beautifully with a shoulder rest and chin rest that gives you a really comfortable posture as a player. And I will do another episode about that sometime soon. But today I'm going to talk a little bit about what you can do to kind of relax your body and stretch out. Firstly, the setup of the instrument needs to be 100% right. Secondly, you need to have a relaxed posture. So make sure that your teacher teaches you a relaxed posture. If you keep coming up with tensions, I would actually recommend either talking to your teacher, talking to a physio and your teacher, or literally change teachers. If the style you're being taught is causing you to tense up your body and create injuries, then you need to change the style, your playing style. This is really important. And it's not something to joke about, because having health issues like that can affect your whole life. And I don't care how good a teacher is with the kind of results they're getting. If the students are getting injuries, something needs to change. Either the teacher needs to learn something different, or you haven't actually been following the teacher perfectly. But anyway, something needs to change. So today I'm actually going to focus on a little exercise I found. So what's really important is that as a student that you learn a super relaxed posture, and that your shoulders, when you're playing, that your shoulders are mostly dropped, and that your neck feels relaxed, and that your hands and fingers feel relaxed. There's actually more that goes down all the way to the stance, all the way down to your feet. But for now, that's the main thing I'm going to focus on. My work actually causes me to tense up sometimes. When I get a bit stressed, or when I do some really fine work, I find myself just lifting my shoulders and working like this. And when I do that, my whole neck and shoulders start hurting, and I can end up with headaches. And so, believe it or not, even violin makers have to watch their posture. So I've been looking around for ages just trying to find some exercises that might help me, and I found one exercise that helped me a lot personally, and today I want to share that exercise with you. So if you're finding yourself getting tense when you're playing, firstly, obviously you need to change your posture to make sure you're relaxed. Secondly, one thing you can do is you can just stop, shake out everything, and then start again. So when you're playing, you're feeling pain, put your instrument down, and just for 30 seconds to 60 seconds, shake everything out, then pick up your instrument again and start again with a relaxed feeling posture. Or if you're playing cello, this, or double bass, or viola. No, I'm kidding, viola isn't that far out. But this one exercise I wanted to share is called an Egoscue exercise. So it was invented by a guy called Peter Egoscue, and he's got an entire system built around it. Now, I'm not promoting this one system. I just found this one exercise in that system that really, really helped me personally. Again, I'm not a doctor, nor am I a physio. So if you've got any pains, you know, don't just watch my video, also talk to your physio or doctor or something like that. But in the meantime, you can try this exercise and see if it works for you. And yeah, I found that it really helped me. Now I'm gonna show you this exercise today. So I'm gonna show you a video that I found, a YouTube video, and I'll share the link, give the guy a bit of an extra plug because I think the exercise is fantastic. But then I might actually go upstairs to my favorite room in the house and do it up there. I'll see you up there. Bye. I'm gonna do this exercise in my favorite room in the house. Upstairs, we get these lovely views. So I really love this room.
We're gonna start out with the arm circles. The standing arm circles are done with your feet pointed directly straight ahead. So remember, if your feet are out like this and your pelvis and shoulders are kind of dropped down and relaxed into bad posture, all you have to be thinking about is straightening up your feet and getting your toes fist width apart so that your feet are dead straight, almost feeling like they're turned in or slightly pigeon-toed.
So, we've got to form this fist, okay? And we keep our feet a fist width apart, and then you do the turns forward.
Up, and then circle up and back 40 times. Try to make full circles. Don't just move the arms back and forth like this. It's a full circle motion to get it done for the 40 repetitions.
And you turn your palms up and you do them backwards 40 times.
Same hand position, place it against your temples and then thumbs down, close your elbows together in front of you, open them up. Try to close them right at your chin level and then open, close, open. Drop your shoulders again. Lock your arms out, take that up over your head to where your shoulder stops the movement. Now, when I'm in this position, I'm lightly looking up like this. I'm not leaning way back. I'm just looking up at my hands, and then I'm trying to bring my arms back the entire time, make it a little bit more active.
And the funnest part,
the one last exercise I want to show you is, remember, what I call the ultimate abdominal exercise. You're gonna set yourself up as if you were gonna go on a 50 or 100 yard sprint. Come up off the heel and the back foot, have it turned out about 45 degrees. The weight's on both feet, but really loaded up on this front leg. And then the motion is just with your arms, just as if you were gonna go sprinting. So I'm showing you the slow motion right now just so you can see. We're gonna do this, and then you start going full speed. And you can hear what it's done to my breathing and my talking, because my deep abdominal muscles and my peripheral abdominal muscles have to contract along with my back and hip muscles to stabilize this movement.
What I really love about that exercise, it really opens up your, you know, helps you relax your shoulders, drop your shoulders properly. Quite often my neck cracks afterwards and my neck feels a lot better. I sometimes can even get rid of a migraine headache that way. But also, I feel so much more relaxed and open afterwards. And I think for string playing, it's gonna make such a big difference. You know, if you have nice and relaxed shoulders and nice and relaxed neck, it's just gonna make your life so much easier when you're playing. So, you know, this is one option for an exercise that you can try that could work really well. I am not a specialist, so, you know, do your research. But it's just, we're always looking for ways to improve ourselves as string players. And having a relaxed body is really, really important. I personally think that part of learning violin, that teachers should always help their students find strategies to play in a more relaxed way. And keep their bodies healthy. I see so many professional players that actually have to have, you know, special physio done or anything like that, because they never really learned how to really hold their body properly and how to stay super relaxed while they're playing. So it's really important. Anyway, all the best. Keep having fun playing, make beautiful music. And now you can make beautiful music in a more relaxed way. Yeah, make sure you stay relaxed when you're playing. And if you feel yourself tensing up, just put your instrument down, just shake out for a little bit, and then start again so that, you know, that you keep that relaxed posture when you're playing. Because if you're playing with a relaxed posture, firstly, you'll have much better health. Secondly, I think you will play better. I think having a relaxed body will actually allow you to express yourself better. Isn't it amazing? We've just had a bit of a thunderstorm, so it's a bit windy behind me here. But I really wanted to do this in this room because it's my favorite room in the house. Anyway, if you like this video, hit the like button, click on the subscribe button, and hit the little bell so that you find out every time I post a new video. Okay, see ya!